Here at Mr. Nectarline's class, one can expect a challenging learning environment with one-on-one teaching.
If you love science, then MST Biology is for you. MST Biology is a high-level science course that anyone can take at the Frederick V. Pankow Center. MST Biology consists of both honors and AP courses. In these courses, academics are more challenging and quicker paced than a normal biology class at your high school. These courses are made like this to help students prepare for college-level classes. So what do you say? Join MST Biology today.
Good evening, everyone out there. My name is John Haas. I'm the director here at the Pankow Center, where we have our MST program housed. This is a unique setting for all of us. We really appreciate you tuning in. We really appreciate your interest in the MST program as well. Tonight is going to be a program of some live discussion, live introductions, live Q&A, if you'd like. As well as a pre-recorded piece that really is more of the formal part of our presentation tonight about the program. A little bit about myself before we introduce the entire staff. I've been the director here for about 8 years. I was a counselor here for four, and my first half of my career was spent at Lonsbruce High School, where I was a science teacher and a guidance counselor as well. I've been a part of the district for 26 years now. I was a student here at the district from about first grade all the way to my senior year. So my blood runs pretty thick for Las Creuse. It's a pleasure to be here. And there's one thing about Las Creuse: they have invested in this math science program, and I truly, truly feel it is a gem of a program, and one that we certainly would like for you to truly take a look at tonight and see, students, if this is the right fit for you. So before we get into the formal part of the program, we want to give everyone an opportunity who's a teacher in our program a chance to introduce themselves, tell you a little bit about their background, what they teach here, what they've taught in the past. And we're gonna get things kicked off here with our first teacher. She teaches our 11th grade math and science, as well as some of our senior calculus programs. And I'm going to kick it off to Mrs. Anne Marie Duncan. There she is. Anne Marie, take it away.
Thanks, Mr. Haas. Hi, guys. I'm Anne Marie Duncan. I teach, as Mr. Haas said, MST Honors Pre-Calculus to the juniors, and I also teach AP Calculus BC to seniors. I've been in Las Creuse schools for over 30 years. I started my career at Las Creuse North for about 18 years, and then I came here to the Pankow Center. I've been here for the remainder of my career. Love this building, and I love this program. I hold a bachelor's from Michigan State University and a master's from Saginaw Valley. I really do believe that we provide our students with just some great opportunities here, and I'm really excited that you're here to learn more about it.
Thanks, Mrs. Duncan. Her teammate in the 11th grade, at least, and then with some of the seniors, is Dr. Rhonda Deliberti. There she is. Rhonda, take it away.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Rhonda Deliberti, and I teach 11th grade honors physics and 12th grade AP physics here in the program. I have an undergraduate degree from Central Michigan University with a major in chemistry, physics, and a minor in biology. I also have graduate degrees from Wayne State and Saginaw Valley, and most recently completed my PhD program at Oakland with a degree in online and blended learning. I've been teaching for 30 plus years. I spent many years at Las Creuse High School. I spent a couple of years at LCN And I also spent a year at the International Academy of Macomb. I think one of the best things about the MST program is that it gives students the best of both worlds. While they're here at Pankow, they're in accelerated math and science classes in a small school environment, but they still have a traditional high school experience as they're connected to their home school for the second half of the day. My advice to students and parents who are trying to decide between programs is to come visit each program in person. Call our office, make an appointment, and come see our students and teachers in action. Thank you.
Thanks, Dr. Deliberti. We're going to move to our 10th grade instructors. We're going to start off with our math teacher at the 10th grade level, as well as she also teaches our AP statistics class, and that is Miss Lori Ferrari. Lori, hello there.
Good evening, Mr. Haas. How are you?
I'm fantastic.
All right. I'm Lori Ferrari, and I am the 10th grade Algebra 2 teacher here in the MST program, and I also teach AP statistics, and that course is offered to both juniors and seniors. So I did my educational background is going to sound really similar to Dr. Deliberti. I did my undergrad a long time ago at Central Michigan University, did graduate work at Wayne State University and Saginaw Valley, but that's where it ends. I don't have a PhD. I have been at Pankow for about 8 years, and I spent the majority of my career before this. I was at LCN, but I did spend time also at Lance Creuse High School, so I was a Lancer as well. And I also spent a year at the International Academy of Macomb. I landed back here at Pankow of my own free will and desire. I love this program. I love the students. I love the staff. I love the building. And I think, as Dr. Deliberti suggested, if you come visit, I think you'll see why and how why we all enjoy being here so much.
Thanks, Mr. Ferrari. Next up is our 10th grade science teacher who teaches chemistry as well as AP chemistry to our upperclassmen, and that's Mrs. Allison Garmo.
Good evening, Mr.
Allison. Take it away.
Thank you. My name is Allison Garmo. I've been a teacher in this district for 20 years, 13 of it spent at Pankow, and the previous 7 at the high school. I teach 10th grade honors chemistry, and then I teach AP chemistry to our seniors and some select juniors. I have a bachelor's degree in biomedical sciences from Grand Valley State University, and I have a master's degree from Saginaw Valley State University in administration. And one of the things I love best about being here is simply the collaboration that takes place between the teachers, the students, and the staff in general, and the other programs that are here at Pankow. And I'll talk a little bit later how we actually try to link our different grades and our different classes. But it's a very unique experience. Thank you.
Thanks, Mrs. Garmo. And last but not least, our 9th grade instructors. These two will be who you see 8th graders next year if you get into the program and decide to attend. We're going to start off with our biology teacher. You caught a little picture of her in that teaser clip before we got started here. But Ms. Chandler Missick is our biology teacher. There she is. Go ahead, Chandler. Introduce yourself for us.
Awesome. Hello, everybody. My name is Chandler Missick, and I am the honors biology teacher here, and I also teach AP biology to sophomores and juniors. This is my 4th year teaching, and I've been lucky enough to be teaching for all 4 of these years in the MST program. I graduated from the University of Michigan with a bachelor's degree in science and a master's degree in educational studies, and I'm currently going back for my education specialist degree at Oakland University. My favorite part of MST is the family feel that we have here. I tell my freshmen on the first day of school to look around the room, and even though they don't recognize many people, that everyone will one day feel like family. And by the time their freshman year ends, and surely by the time they're about to graduate as seniors, everyone in their classes is not just a classmate. It really does feel like family. And I think that's fostered by the collaboration that our students are closely working together in a rigorous environment for 4 years, and also the relationships that students are able to build with teachers. We don't just get to know your student's name, we get to know who they are. And I think all of that really fosters that family feel.
Thanks, Ms. Missick. And Ms. Missick's partner, the lone male on the MST staff, but surely one of the most recognizable people on the staff, as he stands about 6'7". Mr. Jim Neckerline, our MST geometry teacher, but he also teaches some upper level classes, and I'll let him explain those to you. Take it away, Jimmy.
Thank you so much, Mr. Haas. My name is James Neckerline. I've been teaching since I started out in 2000 in Marine City. I was there for 1 year. The assistant principal there and one of the teachers were both taller than me, which doesn't even make sense. So I had to scoot. So luckily I loved it there, but luckily I found myself here in 2001, where I was at Lance Creuse North for about 10 years. And then after that, I moved here. So I've been here for the last 10 years. So I teach MST geometry, freshmen. So hopefully I'll have your students next year. Super excited to meet them for sure. I also teach AP biology and AP calc for seniors. So I do that as well. I went to Michigan State. From there, I got a couple degrees, I think, at Saginaw Valley State. So I've got a few degrees, I guess, as well. But for me, the best thing about this program is absolutely the kids. So, you know, it is, to me, such an incredible gesture that when your students choose to come here, they're choosing to take a challenge. That means so much to me. It also, they opt to come here. So since they opt to come here, you know, that for me is an honor. You know, like, they literally chose to come here, have me, Ms. Missick, and all the rest of our teachers here as their teachers. And for me, having students with the passion and also, I guess, the confidence to take on a challenge, especially when you're transitioning into your freshman year, knowing it's already going to be a challenge. Then on top of it, they're willing to even go beyond that. So to have those like-minded students that are all passionate and motivated and willing to take a chance, I think, is just such an exciting opportunity for me personally. So, yeah.
Well said, Mr. Neckerline. Well said. So we are going to get into the next part of our program. This part is recorded. I recorded this last week with Mr. Kaufman, our TV and broadcast instructor, and it's about 40 minutes long. It does have a PowerPoint slide presentation. It goes along with some descriptions and explanations and that sort of thing. So we will see you back live in about 40 minutes. So sit back and take a look at the program.
Well, welcome back. I appreciate all the teachers introducing themselves. Normally, this part of the evening is dedicated right next door to me over in the JPAC, where we are live in the auditorium, going over a more formal presentation of the MST program. But for tonight, because of the pandemic that we're in, we are going to do this virtually, and we're actually going to do this part pre-recorded. You saw my mask on. I just took it off. I just want everyone to know that I am all alone in a studio. We have our very decorated TV and broadcast media instructor, Mr. Michael Kaufman, in a studio behind very thick glass, playing a puppeteer kind of role right now tonight for us to be able to pull this off. We thank him for everything that he's doing for us tonight, but there's no one anywhere near me, so I feel safe taking off my mask and being able to be a little bit more intimate with all of you. The math science program is just a small piece of what makes up our Pankow Center. We're going to talk an awful lot about the MST program tonight, but there are also a couple things you want to know about Pankow as well. Our performing arts program is made up of our dance classes and made up of our English and acting program. MST is something that, you know, students test into, rank, and get offered a seat. Our performing arts programs are also programs where students need to audition to get into. So whether it's dance or the acting portion of the English acting class, your incoming freshman would have the opportunity to be in both programs as a ninth grader. Our CTE programs are really what the founding courses are to Pankow even being built back in the mid-70s. CTE is made up of a conglomerate of classes that include our health science classes, our auto tech classes, auto collision, culinary arts, a lot of programming classes, graphic arts, early childhood, horticulture science, our TV broadcast class that we're filming in right now. These programs and several others make up our CTE course offerings. And finally, our cognitively impaired program. Our CI students make up about 40 students that come to Pankow on a regular basis. Again, they were one of the original programs that occupied Pankow back in the 70s and 80s. And they truly are a very beloved group of kids that come here. They mingle into some of our CTE classes and even our PA classes at times. But all of our Gen Ed students truly, truly wrap their arms around our CI population. You've had the opportunity to meet all of our teachers here in MST just a few minutes ago. One person that isn't a part of tonight's program is our associate director, Mr. Dean Sablehouse. Again, that guy's a fixture here at Pankow. He was our construction ed teacher for many, many years. He was a social studies teacher at Lance Creuse High School back in the 90s, where I got my start. He and I are not only truly great friends, but we make up the administrative team here at Pankow. What is the MST program, and what is its advantages to your students and to all of our 10th, 11th, and 12th grade students after they've been here since ninth grade? They've got a truly great opportunity where they've got a curriculum that really is enriching in math and science. And we'll get into why that is versus maybe some of the honors level and AP level classes that are offered at Lance Creuse and Lance Creuse North. But what really makes MST unique right from the get-go for your incoming ninth grader is that they will be coming in as a cohort group. And what does that mean? All right, a cohort group means that they are going to be coming in not only in ninth grade, but they're going to stay together in 10th grade, in 11th grade, and in 12th grade. They're going to be surrounded by students who have like-minded passion for math and science. They're going to be in an environment of a class of around 28 students, but as they move along in 10th and 11th and 12th grade, students make decisions. Students hit walls, and our 110 to 115 person freshman class will dwindle by 10% every year. So that makes our class sizes a little bit smaller every year. The MST students also have the opportunity to stay connected to classmates that they knew in middle school, that they've known in elementary school, by taking English and social studies and other electives at their two home schools. They're able to stay involved in athletics. We have several MST students at all four grade levels that compete athletically, that stay involved in their music programs and choir and in band, and overall stay involved with all of the different clubs and opportunities that Lance Creuse and Lance Creuse North offer them. The friendships that our students create here in MST really, really are unique because they're not just with students from Middle School East or Middle School North or Middle School Central or South anymore. They come not only to MST to be with students from that sister middle school on their end of the district, but they are now in class with students from both high schools. So they're going to walk in ninth grade, be in Mr. Nectarline's bio class or Ms. Mystic's bio class or Mr. Nectarline's geometry class, and truly look around, and they're going to see students from all four middle schools sitting in front of them or on either side of them. The friendships they create, I've talked to numerous MST students over the years, and some of their best friends in high school actually go to the other high school. The teaching methods that our teachers expose to students really surround themselves around the final point. Some of the things that they are able to do can't be duplicated at Lance Creuse or Lance Creuse North because of the scheduling and team teaching approach that is offered to MST by having math and science back to back with one another and having the same teachers in ninth grade, the same teachers in 10th grade, and the same teachers in 11th grade from one semester to the next. Some additional things that are advantages to being in the MST program. later throughout the program, when they get into their junior and senior year, they're going to have an opportunity to do a job shadow. They do have to go out and find that job shadowing experience, but at the same time, though, we've been doing this for a couple of years now, and there is a library of different organizations and different office settings and different industries, engineering, medicine, different types of things like that, where current and former students have made those connections, did a few-day job shadow experience, and those businesses and organizations and facilities have said, hey, we're welcome to take any of your future students in. Some AP classes, our advanced placement course offerings that we offer in MST, they're not all offered at the two homeschools. Things like AP Physics C, things like AP Computer Science, classes like AP Calculus BC, those are not offerings that you're going to find at Lance Creuse or Lance Creuse North, but they're here in the MST setting. From the moment, I mean from the moment your student walks into MST, they are going to begin preparing for post-secondary opportunities. Immediately, they start taking practice SAT and ACT tests. Right away, they're going to start seeing their assessments in different units in both 9th grade, 10th grade, and into 11th and 12th grade. Their assessments for each unit are going to have questions that model ACT and SAT questions. They take decommissioned tests right away in 9th grade. They start gaining confidence in themselves when it comes to a standardized test that will be timed. They see the growth in their scores. And I'm going to tell you right now, this is something that I'm going to talk, I'm talking to the students right now. Your grades may not be all A's, but I can pretty much guarantee that your test scores are going to be higher than the average student in the state and probably higher than the average student in your home school, even though you might not be earning all A's, because you are going to be exposed to a learning environment that is just not duplicatable at either high school. Academic support. I mean, from the moment, again, you walk in here, Ms. Missig and Mr. Nectarline are going to be talking about working together in small groups. The days where you sat at your desk in your middle school, where you raised your hand to answer a question, raised your hand to ask a question, went home, found the kitchen table or your desk in your bedroom, and studied by yourself, are over with. You're going to be in small groups in class. You're going to be encouraged to get together after school and work in small groups. You're going to be encouraged to get on FaceTime with one another and work in small groups. And your built-in support isn't necessarily always the teachers. Your built-in support are your classmates. And again, that is not something that I think is fostered and duplicated enough in our homeschools, because again, you may switch math and science teachers at semester time. You may not ever have your ninth grade math and science teacher again. I can guarantee you're going to have them at least one more time by the time you get to your senior year, and you may even go from having Miss Missig ninth grade and having her again in 10th grade. So you not only get to learn your teacher style, but you become exposed to an opportunity to and fostered and challenged and pushed to work with classmates. And that truly is the greatest built-in support academically that you'll get here at MST. However, your teachers are going to challenge you. Your teachers are going to really push you to a level that you've never been to academically. But I'm going to tell you and guarantee you this, they will support you stronger than any teacher you've ever had. They will be there after school. They will be on their Remind app answering questions at 10 o'clock at night on occasion, maybe not every night. They're going to put together review packets, put together pre-recorded videos, put together study sessions that don't happen the night before a final exam, but start happening weeks before final exams. You start getting into the upper level AP classes, they start reviewing a month or two before that AP exam. So your academic support is going to be classmates, but you truly have six teachers who will always be there. Mr. Nectarline, you may have a ninth grade, and you may not have him again. But I'll tell you what, he's going to know your name, and he's going to be supporting you by your senior year, too. There's some unique organizations that you can join in MST, and they're MST-specific organizations. Our MST Leadership Council, Mu Alpha Theta, and the MST Science National Honor Society are three clubs that have, you know, sometimes they do things together and they overlap with purpose, but primarily they have their own set of objectives, their own set of activities and fundraisers and purposes each year to really not only support students academically, but also, you know, bring together kids and classmates that are like-minded in math and science and really want to do things beyond the classroom. Academic competitions. We do have some math opportunities for kids to compete against other students mathematically across the state. And every year, we have students that finish strong in these competitions. It's always fun to see who those students are and how well they excel in these competitions. And then junior year, senior year, this year, unfortunately, it's not going to happen. Okay, but moving forward, and certainly in the past, we've had a group of teachers that would take students to different campuses, whether it's Michigan State, University of Toledo, U of M has been visited. A group of MST students will go with one or two of the instructors and take these visits and get some real strong opportunities, intimate opportunities with professors or certain programs or small colleges within the university that possibly, had you just gone to that school by yourself with your parents, you may not have had that opportunity to see or get a real good look into a certain program. A lot of you probably are looking at IAM, the International Academy of Macomb. IAM could be a great fit for some of you, just as MST could be a great fit for some of you. We really, really encourage you, if IAM might be something on your radar, to certainly exhaust your research. I know you've probably already heard, if you've been interested in IAM, you've heard from people, maybe have gone to the school in some way, whether it's through a virtual tour or possibly a one-on-one tour, heard from their counselor or administration as well. Okay, we encourage you to go for it and take a look at it, because really, both programs, MST and IAM, are a good fit for some, but they're not a good fit for all. And what you're going to find on our website is some of our teachers, we actually have two teachers, Ms. Ferrari and Dr. Deliberti, who both were instructors at IAM a few years ago. So they have firsthand knowledge of IAM, and they put together a document that I think really does a nice job of outlining some of the differences between the two classes, or I'm sorry, between the two programs. And looking at your profile academically, students and parents looking at your child, you may really see where your child's interests, where your child's passions, maybe their background, what their strengths are and what they do well academically in, might align with MST better or might align with IAM better. So we really encourage you to go through the application process in both and hopefully have a couple of options at the end to make the most informed decision between. A lot of people ask us about how does MST help their child get into college? Well, I think one thing we love to do is take a look at data. And we don't have this year's class of 2021's data for this year's presentation, just because not everyone has taken the SAT. It wasn't something that was required for college admissions this year for our current seniors. So we're using a slide from last year's presentation with last year's class of 2020's SAT data. And I think what you're going to find is something, you know, a couple of things that are pretty astounding. Number one, you know, if you don't know, take a look at what a maximum score on an SAT is. Take a look at what the state average is. And then take a look at the next row and see what the class of 2020's composite average was on the SAT. I mean, we're talking 300 points higher than the state average. And then for those that are still deciding between IAM and MST, at this point, you know, take a look at where IAM fell. And this is not some anomaly for the class of 2020. This data holds true from year to year to year, that between MST and IAM, there's a point difference, plus or minus, depending upon which school you're looking at. So I think this is pretty a significant snapshot of test data for you to look at. And even though it's from last year's senior class, it's very similar from the 2019 class, the 2018 class, the 2017 class. The other thing that we've tracked over the years, 2009 was our first graduating class in MST. So for 10 years, from 2009 to 2019, we've kept track. You know, and we put together the stat last year for the presentation. And MST students, specifically seniors, self-report all of the scholarship money that they've been offered between the time they've applied for college, been accepted, and have made their final decisions. And the schools that have accepted them, they kind of add up how much money that they've been awarded before they make that final decision on where they want to go. And each year, on average, each senior class is awarded about $2 million a year. Okay, if you backtrack to my a slide a few minutes ago, I mentioned that by the time you become a senior, your graduating class is significantly less than what the incoming freshman class is. And our goal every year is to keep that freshman class, whatever it's 110 or 115 students, our goal every year is to have 110 finish by their senior year. But on average, we lose about 10% of that population each year. So we finish somewhere between 60 and 65 graduates. This year, we're hoping that we're gonna exceed that and maybe have our highest total of seniors, which would be closer to 70. But that 60 to 65 students each year is being awarded $2 million in scholarship money. Do a little math there and you realize, wow, what a significant amount of money each child is earning or being offered in order to, in their college selection process and thinking about where they want to go and why they want to go to that school. In-state universities, this is just a snapshot again of schools and what Grand Valley's not up here. I know that we have students that go to Grand Valley. And there's some smaller schools that aren't up here. Aquinas College isn't up here. That's a school we've sent students to. So this is just a snapshot of some of the state schools that we've had graduates from MST go to. But here's also a slide of universities that are outside of the state of Michigan that students go to. And we really, really encourage students to reach for the stars when it comes to applying to schools. Because you never know, A, where you're going to get into, and B, what it might cost. I mean, you're gonna see schools that are Ivy League schools like Brown University. You're gonna see schools that are on the west coast of our country, you know, in Arizona State. We're gonna see schools on the east coast. You're gonna see schools down south like University of Alabama, you know. But the more you research and the more you realize that, you know what, maybe the University of Michigan isn't the end-all, be-all school. All right, what if I got into Brown? What if I got into Princeton? You know, if you've talked to any admissions officer from those schools, you're going to quickly find out it might be cheaper to go to one of those schools than it would be the University of Michigan. So we do not sit here and try to cap our graduates and think only that university or Michigan State University. We really want them to go for it and reach and see what happens and see how things all fall into place. And students that are attending these institutions or have attended these institutions certainly have done that. Every year, minus this year, every year we have had an MST Alumni Day. And it usually falls right before Christmas when all of our graduates have come back from college. And again, we didn't do this in December of 2020, but we did it last December in 2019, and we had them do a survey. And out of 50 students who completed the survey that day on Alumni Day, here are some questions that they were asked, and here are some of the responses. And I feel like when you really take a look at this, you're grasping that almost all 50 or at least 45 in some instances felt like the MST workload certainly prepared them for their next level of school. That the MST pacing, how fast they went, how much they drilled down, certainly prepared them. That the rigor of the coursework had them ready for whatever institution they went to after MST and their Lance Creuse experience. And finally, would they choose MST again? And 100% of the 50 students who got surveyed said they would. When they were asked, you know, what are some aspects of MST that they would want to see kept the same? We really, really listen to this, and we really, really try not to change anything when we are seeing, you know, survey after survey, not only in 2019, but in surveys we've done in the past, say the same things. And again, here's a list of them. I'm not going to go in and read every single one of them. All right, but there is one part that I really want to highlight, and that is these middle couple, all right? Cohort environment, family aspect, and relationships between students and teachers. I've said this phrase quite often tonight. There are things about MST that are not duplicatable at home schools, and these are the three things that I think really highlight that phrase. And I think in some of the teasers videos you heard before we got to this point, and what you're going to learn a little bit in a little bit when you see a little bit more extensive video of Mr. Neckerline and Ms. Missick's classes, you're going to hear that come up an awful lot. And that's something we really take pride in. And I think by the time students graduate, they're ready for that same experience when they get to the college level. So asking questions, finding small study groups at the collegiate level, working with kids on their dorm floor, working with lab partners is not foreign to them. It's not something that they shy away from because they haven't had to do it for 4 years. They've been exposed to it from ninth grade forward, and not only, you know, do well with that kind of learning environment, but they have a thirst for it and they want that. And that's really truly why they're so successful, because they talk math and science with other people their age. Other comments that the alumni have said, you know, again, I think you can take a look at this slide and read it for yourself. But I think, again, the bottom line, MST prepared me immensely for college. There are going to be some hurdles that kids go through. Sometimes it might be as early as ninth grade. Hey, they may get through ninth and 10th grade, you know, really not changing any of their habits, but maybe by 11th grade, boom, it hits, you know, and they've got to look in the mirror and say, what do I need to do differently if I want to have the same level of success? And think about it, parents. Would you rather have your son or daughter maybe earn that first B or B minus or C in high school in a rigorous class where they've done everything that they've done the same since seventh grade, and boom, now they've learned they got to change? Do that now when it's free versus their freshman year in college, when all of a sudden some of those challenges and hurdles that they would have faced in MST or fought through in MST that they face as a freshman in college, and you're paying tens of thousands of dollars. I know what I would choose, and I know that our kids are getting that experience. So what does the curriculum look like over 4 years? What are your students' options? In ninth grade, it's pretty limited. All right, in ninth grade, you're going to take Mr. Neckerline for MST geometry, and you're going to take Ms. Missig or MST biology, all right? You're gonna get your feet wet. You're gonna see quickly here what a schedule might look like. You could also, in this case, take the English acting program, which is 1 hour of English, 1 hour of acting here at Pankow, okay? You could also take dance here, which is a 2 hour block. You could take this class, TV and broadcast media, which is a 2 hour block, and use your two elective hours up. So there are some options to stay here at Pankow and take more classes and be here more. But when it comes to MST, it's just those two classes. In 10th grade, some options open up. You will have to take Algebra 2 and you will have to take Chemistry. But if you really wanted to take a third class, you could take Ms. Missig again for her Advanced Placement Biology class. And we've just partnered up now with Mr. Sanborn, and he teaches AP Computer Science, and we've created MST-only sections of AP Computer Science, and you could start taking that as early as 10th grade. In 11th grade, our standard classes are pre-calculus and physics, and then again, you could stay and take, again, AP Bio or AP Computer Science, but you could also potentially take AP Statistics or AP Chemistry. And in 12th grade, it's only AP. You have to take one math, you have to take one science, and if you wanted to stay a third hour, we could then get you into AP Computer Science if you wanted to take a third class. But what does a schedule look like as a freshman? Here's a mock schedule where MST would be in their morning, the first and second hours. MST for 9th, 10th, and 11th grade is also offered 5th and 6th hour. So this student has MST in the morning. They finish up with at their high school with history, with gym, with English, and then another elective. And in a lot of cases, it's foreign language. But let's say you were a student who got into the English acting program. Well, freshman English acting is offered first and second hour. So you would be in English acting first and second hour, go back for history, go back for an elective, whether it's gym or foreign language, okay? And then come back here for English, and then your second elective would be acting. So, you know, this is just kind of a picture of what your schedule, a typical freshman schedule looks like, but keep in mind, MST could be in the afternoon. We have busing. We have busing that takes students from their home school to Pankow for MST. So you're welcome to drop your student off if they had MST first and second hour, like our previous slide showed. You could drop them off here at Pankow instead of dropping them off at North or the high school or having them bus to North in the high school. You would get on a separate bus if that was the case. If you came in from your neighborhood on the district bus, you get on the MST bus and they would bring you here. And if you had MST in the afternoon, you end a few minutes early than the typical homeschool day in order to transport kids back to the homeschools via bus. This year is an anomaly. This year, students are allowed to drive because of the pandemic and because we want to try to minimize the crowding on buses. But typically, it is a closed campus, and I would anticipate this fall that students who are eligible to drive to their home schools are not going to be allowed to drive to Pankow as an upperclassman like they are right now. But we'll see how things go. We'll see how the vaccines go and how we roll them out and how many kids are able to get vaccinated. But at the same time, if it does continue next year, I would anticipate it for sure not in, moving on to the following year. The district prides itself in busing our kids and keeping them safe. The application process. If you have had a son or a daughter go through the MST application process in the past, we have really streamlined this and taken out all of the old school handwritten applications. We've taken out the essay. We've taken out the hard copy app recommendation forms to give to the math and science teachers in eighth grade. We've really done a lot of things to keep it more simple and keep it electronic and routable. So we're not only not handling paper, but things are being delivered much, much quicker. We're not using the US mail. One thing that hasn't changed, we're looking for your son or daughter to have a B or better average in eighth grade in both semesters of algebra and science. If you're not currently in algebra, hold tight. It's going to be okay. We'll talk about how you could become part of the MST class this fall. But 98% of our incoming class usually has taken algebra in the middle schools, are in middle school algebra right now. You find the MST application online. You go through the Lance Creuse website, find the school dropdown, click on Pankow, go to the academic dropdown on the Pankow page, find the MST program, and the MST application should be in the bottom right corner of that page. It's short, it's pretty quick, And once you hit submit, it routes right to me. Again, this used to be something you'd fold up, put in an envelope and a stamp and mail to me. Now it comes directly to my inbox. NWA test. We typically use the winter scores. I believe you guys have taken that this month here in January. That's not something that you're going to have to worry about. If you haven't, then it'll probably be this month here in February. You don't have to send us your scores. Your application puts you on our list that we send to the curriculum office, and your scores are extracted for us. A big change to the whole process, if you've had a current student or a former student come through, the recommendation forms, as I alluded to before, are not handwritten recommendation forms that your teachers used to fill out. So Mr. Kassir at Middle School East does not have to sit there and fill out 40, 50 forms, check some boxes and things like that for us. He'll be able to have a blank form. He will get a list of all the Middle School East applicants, as well as any algebra teacher or math 8 teacher and every science teacher who teaches 8th grade math that has an applicant. They'll get their list and a blank form and simply click and quickly fill out the recommendation forms. That will get routed to me directly. No more, they will not have to give it to the counselor, and the counselor won't have to drive it over to us, nor will they have to put it in district mail. We're gonna get 2020 here, 2021, and actually do things in this generation instead of 2010 like we used to do. So it took a pandemic to do it, but we're doing it. What if my child's non-algebra? This is what I meant, okay? So if you've got a student who's really excelling in 8th grade math right now, this program really sounds like it's something for them, but they're not currently in algebra, go through the process. Do the online application, okay? We will get the rec forms to your 8th grade math and science teachers. They'll fill it out, and you will have to take algebra this spring and summer, okay? Our Launch Creuse summer school program will offer a full year of algebra starting at the end of June, okay, face-to-face. Both homeschools will offer that. Your homeschools will have that registration details later in the spring for you. Or we've had more and more students doing this. If this is something they want to do, they're hopping on to an online provider, let's say like Michigan Virtual, and they're signing up for semester 1 of Algebra 1 and taking it now. In the evenings at home, it's usually a self-paced class, so they're taking their regular school day, and then when they get home and they get done with their homework for Middle School Central, let's say, they are hopping on and completing algebra work and saving second semester of Algebra 1 for the summer instead of trying to do both semesters in a short time span. Okay, so if you're asking me for my recommendation, I would take a look at Michigan Virtual or K-12 or another online provider and take first semester as soon as possible so you don't have so much to do in the summertime. If you're a current Las Cruz Public School student, and what I mean by that is every year we have a handful of applicants that come from St. Mary's or Trinity Lutheran, schools like Emmanuel Lutheran, students that live in our district but currently go to a parochial school. If you're a current Lance Creuse Central, South, East, or Middle School North student, you'll follow this process, which is to make sure that that online application gets completed by February 12th. From that point on, we will route the recommendation form to your math and science teachers, give them 2 weeks to complete their recommendations on each of you, so that by the end of February, we have an application and your rec forms. We'll ask for the winter NWA scores from the curriculum department. And hopefully by April 1st, which is the start of spring break, you guys will all have a letter emailed to you, a decision letter letting you know if you've been accepted, whether you've been denied, or that you've been waitlisted. If you are one of those students who currently don't go to one of our Lance Creuse middle schools, but plan to attend Lance Creuse High School or Lance Creuse North, you will have the same deadlines, but the only difference is that you will take the NWA with me March 11th at 3 o'clock. My plan is to have you come in and take this here at school. We will socially distance you in our computer lab. Typically, we have anywhere from 2 to 5 students who take advantage of this and apply to MST. So we will test you here. If the health crisis worsens and we're not allowed to do that, then we will do it via Zoom on March 11th, okay, which is the way I did it last spring when we were told to stay home by the state government and all face-to-face instruction was suspended. So March 11th, 3 o'clock, here at Frederick V. Pankow Center, plan on taking the NWA with me. Again, your decision timeline is the same. By April 1st, you will know your decision. If you've got any questions, okay, that don't get answered tonight, all right, stay tuned. We're going to come back live here shortly and give you an opportunity to go ask questions in separate discussion rooms with all of our MST staff that you met a few minutes ago. But if you've got any questions after tonight, please email me. Okay, I'll be happy to get back to you and hopefully be able to answer something that doesn't quite get an answer tonight for you. So with that being said, we've got a couple of, you know, 2-3 minute clips about our MST geometry program again with Mr. Nectarline and our MST biology program, AP and Honors Bio with Ms. Missig that we want to show to you now, really get you excited about the opportunities that lie ahead for you this fall. And from there, we'll come back live and reintroduce the teachers and then give you an opportunity to get into a Zoom with them and ask some questions that haven't been answered so far tonight. Thanks again for being a part of tonight. We appreciate it.
MST Biology is a great academic course for anybody who loves anything to do with science.
The main goal of the AP Biology class is to do a lot of critical thinking, see how a lot of biology concepts all come together, and eventually the end goal is for students to pass the AP test, which I have my wall of fame back there to kind of give them an extra incentive to get college credit and to get on the wall of fame.
For the most part, MST Biology is a class that is based around teamwork.
A normal day looks like group discussions, and going deeper than you would usually think in a regular biology class.
We do a lot of group work, a lot of discussions, a lot of activities and projects to really see how all these different ideas can come together.
We typically do a lot of like group activities, group discussions, experiments, labs.
MST Biology is also at a higher academic level than a regular high school biology class.
Students should expect like higher level of learning, but not like to the point where it's impossible and like ready to be challenged.
I think AP Biology is great for students who excel in honors biology and who really are looking for a deeper understanding of the biology concepts that are covered in honors biology. We go way deeper, we go faster, and it's also great just for extra critical thinking skills before going to college.
Students should expect a more rigorous course, but one that's more fun.
And this concludes first semester geometry, you guys.
All right, so my name is Mr. Nectarline. I teach MST Geometry. I have 1 AP Calc class and 1 AP Biology class.
I love it. I mean, the program, it's super fun, and it really gives me a lot of knowledge, and I really like it.
Just the environment. I like being around people who actually, like, care about their work.
They came here, they took a challenge, they decided that they were going to, like I said, challenge themselves. And I think when you have all those kids in the same classroom, to begin with, that gives you a unique situation.
It's really good. It's really great here. Like, it's a lot more supportive than I actually expected at first.
In geometry, you're given a diagram. You have to create the problem, and then from there, you then have to algebraically solve it. So I think having to set up the problem in the first place, not having it just sitting there directly in front of you, but having, like I said, to use critical thinking skills to even conjure up the equation in the first place, I think is a really important thing in learning geometry. I like to get them to understand the questions to begin with, and then I like to give them challenging questions where they kind of work on that problem, and then talk about the problem with the other students, try to figure out what the answer is on their own, and then we go over it.
I want to go into a math science field in college and in my career, so I think it'll be very beneficial.
It's a really good experience, and if you're thinking about it, I really recommend doing it and staying.
Hi there, welcome back. I hope that a lot of this presentation answered a lot of questions for you. Before we get into our Zoom rooms and allow you to ask any potential questions that you still have, each teacher is going to come back and introduce themselves again and talk something specific about the program that either they sponsor, that they really appreciate, and really maybe drill down a little bit more than what I spoke about in that slideshow a few moments ago. So we're going to start off with Mrs. Duncan again. She's our sponsor for the new Alpha Theta program, or chapter, I should say. And I'm going to allow her to kind of talk a little bit more about that and what our chapter does. Take it away, Mrs. Duncan.
Thanks again, Mr. Haas. So in addition to teaching the junior and senior level courses, I'm also the advisor of an organization called Mu Alpha Theta. Mu Alpha Theta is a nationally recognized mathematics fraternity composed of the top math students in the country. We're similar to a National Honor Society, but specific to mathematics. We do a variety of things here at the Pankow Center. One of the most important things we do is we provide tutoring to our student body. So every Tuesday after school for approximately an hour, hour and a half, we run after school tutoring sessions. And the tutoring is done by our Mu Alpha Theta students. I, of course, am here overseeing things, and it allows kids to come in and just get help and support that they might need in a very safe and non-threatening environment. And it's a win-win for both the kids that come in and the kids that are actually doing the tutoring. And so there's a lot of learning going on, and it's a really nice program. We also celebrate Pi Day every year. We do a Digits of Pi contest, and we have other various activities going on to celebrate the occasion. So Mu Alpha Theta looks great on a transcript, on a college application, of course. It shows that you're going above and beyond, the classroom, and being in an academic organization such as Mu Alpha Theta, I think also says a lot about our students. So the other thing I do along with Dr. Diliberti is we plan college visits for the juniors. We typically head to one large campus in the fall and a smaller campus in the spring, just so the kids can get a feel for what it's like to be on a college campus. And it's a great experience. It's a lot of fun, but it's also a great learning experience. And it really gets the ball rolling and the gears turning. And they're starting to think more and more about, you know, what they plan on doing in the next couple of years and where they might like to go and what they might like to study when they get there. So if you have any questions about these things or anything else that I might be able to help you with, feel free to join me on Zoom in a little bit. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Mrs. Duncan. Dr. Diliberti is going to take it away next. Dr. Diliberti, I think you're talking about job shadowing experience. It's changed a couple times in my notes, so hopefully it's job shadow. And when you're ready, are you there? There she is. If it's job shadow, great. If it's not, let everyone know what it is, and I'm anxious to hear what it is.
Sounds great, John. Thank you. As John mentioned, yes, I'd like to talk a little bit more about our job shadow requirement. And I also want to spend a few minutes talking about our MST class trips. So in addition to the academic requirements of the MST program, our students must also complete a 15-hour job shadow experience. The purpose of the job shadow experience is to help students learn more about a career that may be of interest to them, or to help them narrow the field if they have many career interests. The job shadow experience also gives our students a chance to interact with adults and to learn some soft skills that are valued in the workplace. Mrs. Duncan and I introduced the job shadowing project to the students in the fall of their junior year. And then students are able to complete this requirement during the fall, or I'm sorry, during their junior year, or during the summer between their junior year and their senior year. And that's when most of them do it. And although students are not allowed to work directly with a parent or family member, we do encourage students to network with family and friends to help secure a meaningful and rich experience. The job shadow requirement has really proven to be a valuable experience for our students. When we read their reflection pieces each year, we can hear the excitement in their voices and feel the enthusiasm for all that they have learned. Many of our students have also been offered summer jobs or internships as a result of their job shadow experience. Unfortunately, due to COVID, last year's students, and most likely this year's students, are unable to complete the job shadow requirement. But we do look forward to continuing the program in the future. And before I finish, I'd also like to mention our MST class trip. So during most years, we plan a 4 to 5 day trip that is optional and open to all MST students. The purpose of this trip is to build relationships with students outside the classroom and to further the family-like feel of our program. In the past, we've had between 35 and 80 students participate in the annual class trip, and we visited cities such as Chicago, New York, Boston, Los Angeles, and San Diego. And unfortunately, last year's trip to California was canceled due to the pandemic, and we are not planning a trip for this year. But once we resume, we hope your son or daughter will be able to join us. If you have any questions about the job shadow experience or the class trips, you can ask any one of us about this in the breakout rooms. Hope to see you there.
Thanks, Dr. Delverde. Next up is Ms. Ferrari. She's going to just kind of highlight some additional Pankow opportunities that your son or daughter might be able to take advantage of in their 4 years here. Take it away, Ms. Ferrari.
Thank you, Mr. Haas. Yeah, so one of the things that I've noticed through the years that I've been here is I think that sometimes students think once they join MST, they can't do anything else. It's going to take so much of their time. But first of all, when it comes down to student activities, you know, things like band or other music programs or other things back at the homeschools, they can still do all that same stuff that they used to. But the other thing that they really should think about is, as Mr. Haas mentioned during his presentation earlier, the Pankow Center is not just the home of MST. The Pankow Center actually houses several different programs, and one of them is our career and technical education program, which has a lot of great courses that a lot of our MST students have actually been in the past. So just out of curiosity the other day, I pulled up the course list and I was looking for which ones did I recall a former student being in. And my list was long. It was horticulture, auto body, health occupations, performing arts, TV and broadcast media, graphic design, PC servicing and networking, Java programming, and I think Mr. Haas had mentioned during his presentation earlier also, we now have AP Computer Science offered here at the Pankow Center, which is a great opportunity for our students who very likely could be going into STEM fields. So I just want to really encourage you to not only consider MST, but the other opportunities that are here at the Pankow Center as well.
Thanks, Ms. Ferrari. Mrs. Garmo is going to be up next, and she's going to highlight something she alluded to when she introduced herself, and that is how all 4 years here, our students work on something research-related that culminates their senior year. So, Mrs. Garmo, go ahead and explain what all that means.
Thank you, Mr. Haas. I want to talk a little bit about the lab experience here along with the research project that we do. And I mentioned before collaboration, and that's something we really try to do as you move from the 9th, 10th, and 11th grade. In the 9th grade with Ms. Missig, she focuses on the group aspect and gets the kids working together and really focuses also on the presentation portion of it, whether it's uploading things to Schoology or if it is presenting in front of a class, they get that experience and that opportunity to really work together. Then when they move to the 10th grade, we learn more about the lab skills. We try to run the experiments from start to finish and really learn how to write a formal lab report that colleges would want to see in a college chemistry class. We also try to have students create their own lab from start to finish. And because of COVID for the last couple of years, we haven't been able to do that. But they actually design their own lab and they run it through, they report it out, and then we have kind of a science fair feel to it. And then when they move to their junior year, Dr. DeLiberti adds some advanced skills with data analysis, and they become very proficient using either Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel. So we can kind of get rid of the fluff that they're used to putting into a presentation and make it more scientific. With those skills, we then take all three grades, the 9th, 10th, and 11th, and we work on a research project. In the past, we've done the Flint water crisis. We've worked on climate change. We tried to do COVID last year, and we're trying to do vaccines for this year. And we introduce the topic to them all at the same time for each of the grade levels. And then they research their component of it. And then we take the kids in the 9th grade, 10th grade, and 11th grade that are in the same hour, and we have them pair up with the people in the other hours that are working on the same topic. And they're able to pick and choose the information maybe they didn't find before, or maybe a question comes up that they didn't think of. And then they bring that information back to their classes and present out, and we make a professional document and presentation that we can share with the entire school and hopefully the community.
Thanks, Mrs. Garmo. Our last two speakers, again, are going to address a couple of things. We're going to start off with Mr. Nectarline. He's going to reiterate some of the things that we've talked about already, but really from his perspective, and that's the family environment here at Pankow and specifically in the MST program. Mr. Nectarline, take it away, buddy.
All right. Thanks again, John. So I'm pretty much a one-track speaker here when it comes to what I think is the best thing about this program. As I taught you guys earlier, it's about the kids. I think when you watch that video about me, I talked about challenges and how much I respect the students for taking on this challenge. So I think, to me, as a teacher, when it comes to freshmen, especially, also I would argue freshman parents, is that there is a chance that your students are going to get challenged, maybe more so than they've ever been before. And for me, that's one of the greatest things about this program is taking students outside of their comfort zone, seeing just how much they're really capable of doing, finding, is with challenge, I just want to reiterate, in terms of what I'm trying to say right now, is that, with challenge, we all want to take a challenge because we all have this idea that we're going to succeed just remarkably and beautifully, and it's all going to work out. But we also are, especially us parents, teachers, we're aware that sometimes things don't work out the way that you want. And when you fail, and failure could be a student getting a C for the first time ever, or studying really hard and getting a B plus, or who knows what, for all of us, failure is different. But when we're sitting here and we have this family environment and we have this support system and we have teachers that are, ultra aware of kids and their feelings and their concerns, and we have parents, of course, that are also worried about how their kids are going to do. We've got administrators here who are 100% on board with the success and failures of the students, realizing that to me, when it's all said and done, taking on the challenge is automatically the success. There's no other end to a challenge other than success. Either you find out you can do something that you couldn't do before, or you find out that you struggled, that you didn't do what you wanted to do, but guess what? Life went on, You learn from something from it. Quick thing, and I'm talking way too much, but I remember the coach for U of M, he said, he was asked, and I love his quote. They asked, this is the first time he coached U of M basketball team. They asked him, reporter asked him, this is the first loss of the season for you guys. What do you think? And he goes, what do you mean that's our first loss? There's no such thing as losing, there's learning. And I agree. I couldn't agree with that statement anymore. So when we have all of these students here that are, working hard and they have common purpose and things like that, and their successes and failures and things like that, I think it adds so much to the program that you can struggle with the confidence that you're going to have all of the support. So that family aspect to it is just so important to me. And lastly, you know, I just want to reiterate something else I'd often say is, to me, this is the time in a kid's life, a freshman's life especially, when you're going into a school, you're going into high school, and you know it's a big deal. You've been living your whole life for high school. You know it's going to be different. You're accepting the challenge. You know maybe things aren't going to go well, and you already have this mindset that you might have to adapt to a new world. So we can foster this new world for them, and we can do it in like I say, said, a way in which we create this family atmosphere that makes your kids feel comfortable. So, you know, just lastly is, when you foster that environment and kids learn this resilience at this age, it's so important for when they get to college and later on in life to learn this now rather than later. So that, to me, I think is the most exciting thing about the program, is watching each student's successes and failures. So anyways.
Thanks, Mr. Nectarline. And last but not least, Ms. Missig, she is going to touch on a couple of the other organizations that we have here in MST. That's the Leadership Council, and that's the Science National Honor Society. So explain what those are, Chandler.
Perfect. Thanks, Mr. Haas. So yeah, I am the advisor of two of our other clubs here at MST, one being our Science National Honor Society. So Mrs. Duncan mentioned how Mu Alpha Theta is the Honor Society for math here. Science National Honor Society is the Honor Society for science. Before COVID, we were doing in-person weekly science help days, but since COVID has kind of pushed us all into more virtual platforms, we've switched gears and done a mentoring program this year where we're pairing any freshman or any underclassman who is just seeking additional help in a subject is getting paired with an older and more experienced student, maybe a student who's taken 2 years of biology, who can work with them one-on-one on their own time in that certain subject area. So that's one big thing that the Science National Honor Society does. We also do a lot with bringing in guest speakers from our community who are in different science fields, so our students can see if they love science, what could they do with science after high school. And we've done some cool hands-on things as well. We partnered with Michigan State's Medical School 1 year to do a suture clinic, and we're hoping that post-COVID, activities like that are possible again. I also am the advisor for our MST Leadership Council, which is MST's version of student council. And it's kind of cool because student councils at the home schools can be super big and dealing with much bigger tasks. We're at leadership. With our leadership council, we're dealing more with projects aimed at MST and aimed at the community around us. So our leadership council is broken into a social and community relations committee. The social committee does a lot of social events for MST. So we've done lock-ins. We have a family program where we pair up a freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior together. We've done a tailgate for the LCN-LCHS football game. And then for the Community Relations Committee, we have adopted a family before for Christmas time. We've done a school supply drive where we donated school supplies to the Macomb County Sheriff's Department, who distributed them throughout the county. So again, it's just another way to get involved, to meet fellow MST students, and to have a greater impact on the community around us.
Awesome. Thanks, Ms. Missig. So we are about ready to conclude the presentation part of tonight. As you see scrolling down below my chin here, the application deadline is February 12th. So please, that's only 10 days out. There have been dozens of you that have already applied. I haven't checked this week, but we were over 65, I wanna say near 70 before the weekend. I'm sure that total has gone up. Please sign off. We appreciate you being here tonight. We appreciate you having the interest in the MST program. Have a great night. And again, if you've got any questions after tonight, feel free to email me.